On the agenda tonight, we're going to be having a listen to and taking a look at Patsy Cline performing I Fall to Pieces. Hello, Phil here from Wings of Pegasus, and welcome to another analysis video. If you enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. So, we have looked at Patsy Cline previously, and I'm going to leave a link to that video at the end of this video, because in that video we looked at her history and career, and we looked at her voice in detail. We're going to be doing the same tonight, because we have her isolated vocal, and we have the pitch monitoring software. To begin with, we're going to be listening to the record and the isolated vocal from the record back in 1961. I'm going to compare this with a live performance as well, so we get an appreciation of the difference between the two, but let's jump straight into it.
I fall to pieces each time I see you again.
I'm just going to jump in here because Patsy had such a natural sense of pitch, especially when we're jumping from one note to another note that is actually quite a distance. She just had that ability to be bang on. Even just where I've stopped it here, you can see the G4 absolutely dead on, slightly sharper the F4, but this just all sounds pitch perfect to the ear. And looking here, even on the D4, when I just take it back a little bit, we'll just cycle back, you can see that pretty much we are always getting pretty close to these lines. It's not auto-tune, so it's not going to be directly on lines, but it's just going to sound perfect to the ear because she is so close, just a few cents sharp, a few cents flat. Let me just explain. On this graph, we've got all of our notes here. Say, for example, this G4 going up to the A4, and here coming back down to the G4, you can see this is pretty much dead on the G4 here. Now, between the G4 and the G#4, there are 100 cents, and that's how 440 hertz tuning works with standard tuning. We've got 100 points between G4 and G#4 that you can hit that will register. So this is why, when I've said in other videos that nobody sings at 0 cents in terms of the accuracy all the time, being perfectly on a line, they're always slightly sharp, slightly flat. They might be on that line just temporarily, but they'll always get the expression of the voice in there. So this is when I'm referring to the more modern vocals where we can see the auto-tunes being used. That's got that zero variation on the note. It's going 0 cents. It's not one out of 100 sharp and 100 flat. It's not even one out. So when we're looking at a fantastic voice like this, who just has great natural, just pitch perfect ability, you can see the variation that we get. Sharp of the F4 here, and then touching the note on the G4, but then sharp of the A4, and you can see F4 bang on again. We can see that natural variation of particular notes being sharp or flat, because that's the best note. That's what sounds the best. It doesn't always conform to 440 hertz tuning. So with that said, we can see that we start on the F3, And let me just obliterate this for a second to show you the ranges up on screen. The F3 is right at the bottom of the contralto range. So we've got a low female voice here, but she does take her voice all the way up to A4, I believe, in this performance. So range-wise, we're then getting up to our A4, which is here, and we are covering over an octave. So I always say that about the best vocalists. They have that range to cover, and we certainly get that with Patsy. But let me get that off the screen so we can now see the vocal wave. And here, this really even vibrato. Again, it sounds exactly as it looks, which isn't always the case with the pitch monitoring software, but it just is so even. I'm going to take it back. We'll have a listen to this, because have a listen to the slides as well, which you'll be able to see on the screen as they ascend and descend.
I fall to pieces.
So that whole first phrase was actually continuous. So here we had the F3 sliding up to the G3, sliding back down again, and we went all the way from the F3 to the F4. So we've got the octave slide. Again, another common feature of great vocalists, especially in the 60s, they had this ability to not only have that range of an octave, but to slide from one octave to the next and be super accurate with it. Look at the F4, and we've got this vibrato that is just so evenly spaced. It's not a vibrato that's always covering the same pitch. I mean, we are pretty tight here. We're not going up as far as a semitone, you know, sharp or flat. So it's a really controlled, tight vibrato. It's so controlled that you've got even less room for error because of how tight that vibrato is. The wider the vibrato, the more notes you cover, therefore the less accurate you have to be pitch-wise, because your vibrato will encapsulate and involve the other notes around the note that you're singing. So the brain and the ear just takes in the average value of whatever note you are vibratoing around. Just fast forwarding quickly, because what I love about the pitch monitoring software is you do get to see where she's absolutely bang on the D4 here, for example, and the F4 as well. I mean, slightly sharp, but then bang on. So she's one of those singers that has such great appreciation of pitch that she will be hitting notes dead on where they need to be hit, and then will be slightly sharp, slightly flat, where those notes need to be flat. And this all ties in with the expression of the voice and the lyrical content. Sometimes to get a particular emotion to stand out a little bit more, you will be slightly sharp, because it's not a machine singing, it's a human singing. And that's just the tendency. Like when you become a little bit more agitated, your voice will naturally increase in height or pitch, because you are putting across that emotion. Like when you get angry, nobody's voice when they're shouting ever goes really low like Barry White. It always ascends because of the emotion in the voice. So that's what we get with singing. That's why the vocals never sit on lines all the time, unless they've been manipulated. But we'll jump back into the isolated vocal. Another thing that really stands out about these great singers is that you can just listen to their voice. You don't need any of the backing, because it stands on its own as something that's intriguing, it's interesting, and it takes you on a journey even without the music in the background, which is amazing to be so captivated by a voice. But that's what great singers can do. Anyway, let's get back into it.
I fall to pieces.
Just quickly mixing it up, she didn't blend these first two notes of the verse this second time round. Again, variation, making it interesting, but just a great vocalist with so many different ways of delivering the same vocal with the same notes to make it sound different the second time around.
Each time someone speaks your name, I fall to pieces. Time only adds to the flame. You tell me to find someone else to love, someone who'll love me too.
Love me too.
The the way you used to do. But each time I go out with someone new, you walk by and I fall to pieces. You walk by and I fall to pieces.
And there we have it. Really interesting in this vocal. It's great to hear the reverb that we have on that original record isolated, because it gives it a haunting quality. But right at the end there, look at the way that Patsy goes from the F4 slides down to bang on the F3 and then comes back up to, I mean, that's about as accurate as you're ever going to get on a D4 with a natural voice. The last note that she holds, you can see the lack of consistency in her vibrato, but this is the emotion in that vocal. It's almost like anguish. It's putting across the lyrical content through her voice, and this is why it isn't even. Because if this was even, you wouldn't get the same expression in the last note of the song. Just with the vocal by itself, you can feel the emotion in this performance, and that's something that Patsy had in her voice. That cry that I mentioned in that previous video I did just connects with you on such a deep level. The other thing is her dynamic appreciation when she's delivering a vocal. Well, listen to this end phrase again, because we get to hear that where she goes, "You walk by," and she starts with more of an airy sound and then leans into it, and then she comes all the way down, and that last note, it's almost as if when she's delivering that, she's close to crying, because when you get close to that kind of place, you can't control your voice, as everybody will know, because you start to sound very silly when you get very emotional with your voice. You can't control your vocal cords, and that's exactly what happens at the end, just putting across that emotion of being that close to crying. So there's such depth in this vocal, especially when you're listening to it isolated, because you get to hear it on a level that you never would with all of the instrumentation going on, the backing vocals going on. Just hearing Patsy's voice in front of this microphone is fantastic, but it gives you such a deeper appreciation of the emotion in her voice. But let's listen to this again.
You walk by and I fall to pieces.
See how she loses the vibrato at the end of pieces on that last line. We are just going to take a quick look at a live performance now to see how it differs to the record. Just to mention about this song, because it was one of those songs that when it was released, Patsy was in her near fatal crash at the time, so it meant that she couldn't go out there and perform it. So it was quite popular, and then it decreased in popularity because she couldn't really do that promotion for the song. And it was a song that she initially didn't want to record because she thought it was too mainstream, too pop. There wasn't enough country in the sound. And when she found out that the Jordanaires were going to be doing the backing vocals, she then didn't want to do it even more because she thought she would be drowned out by their voices collectively. So it was something that, yeah, almost didn't happen, but they definitely wanted to record it. And once they did get it down with Patsy's vocal on there, they knew that it was a hit because of the emotion. I think I read that they were crying. I mean, grown men were crying in the studio listening to this playing back. So they knew they were onto a winner, but it was just one of those things that it would become a lot more popular afterwards and be covered by loads of artists afterwards. But you can see in this live performance that it was after the car crash, of course, and it took a couple of months for Patsy to recover from that. So she has her scars from the crash, but the vocals are so great live. But I mean, have a listen to this vocal, because there is such a difference between this live performance and the record. Let's have a listen.
Ooh.
listen to the amount of cry she's putting into her voice. I've already mentioned this on that previous video, so go and watch that if you want to have a little bit of an explanation about the cry. But it sounds like it's almost that yodel of allowing the voice to almost break and go into that head voice place, but she just controls it. Unbelievable control to have that cry in there all the time. And obviously, being live here, it's a little bit quiet. The mic doesn't pick it up quite as much, so you hear a lot of the crowd sound. And because she sings so dynamically, you do lose her voice in places, but it's just great to hear her control of that cry. And pieces. She pronounces pieces differently live than she did on the record. It's a lot more dramatic. It's just more emphasized in the live version, just getting you to really focus on that word. And that's why it's great to watch great artists live, because they will give you something different in a live performance. Even when the record's already great, they'll give you something else great live. Let's get back into it. Especially on the H's, just allowing that cry to happen. You want me to ride like we've never kissed. You want me to forget. Pretend we've never met. The other thing to look out for are those slides, that when you're focusing on them, you start to hear her sliding into these notes, ascending and descending, which, again, when you're analyzing a voice like this, you just start listening to the voice and forget about all of the techniques that are going on here, the control, the pitch accuracy. It's because just listening to the voice by itself is really interesting. So listening to the voice live and with a band playing live, it just puts it on a different level where you just forget to take in what's going on because you're enjoying the art of the music. But this is an analysis, so I am jumping in, but we'll finish this off. Listen to the end of the performance. Someone who loved me too, the way you used to do. But each time and there we have it. The thing about this song, just in general with Patsy's performance and her delivery of her vocal, is that you believe the song. You believe that she's been through this situation, that everything that she says in that song happened, and it's just a great composition. She didn't write the song. This is another thing to mention about great singers, is they can take somebody's song and make you feel the emotion as if they have been through that, and they can tap into whatever is required to make you feel that and have that connection through their voice. And Patsy just had that ability, a rare thing to be able to do, and to watch a singer that does it on this kind of level. So just an amazing performance live, and a great performance in the studio on that original record. The great thing about a singer like Patsy Cline is when she sang live, it was the same as in the studio. So you can quite easily compare one to the other and isolate one and analyze it, because it would look like that live as well. But thank you guys for requesting this look at Patsy Cline again with the pitch monitoring software. And it's always great to listen to a voice like this. Any excuse to feature Patsy again. But anyway, as always, keep those suggestions coming in the comment section below. Let me know what you guys think. And if you did enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. And I'll see you guys at the next one.
Rock!